Okay. Not quite sure what happened. I think my internet, like, full on cut out. Big rip. So. As I quickly reset up back everything, I am going to quickly take a sip of coffee again. Maybe I should be having something a little bit more healthier than coffee, maybe water, but still really early for me down here, down in the caves. Lord. Alright. So let me just quickly put back up some stuff. Bum bum bum. Gotta say, the Twitch soundtrack is not too bad. It's not bad at all. Here I thought it was going to be some, like, well, it is quite generic, but it's still pretty good. Oh god, everything's ruined. The feng shui of my layout is ruined. All the bad lucky is going to leak out. There's my feed. Plop it back there. Everything in order? Not quite yet. Yeah, I don't know what happened. Everything just cut. Works very mysterious. So. Don't cut on me yet. Hopefully everything is gonna be a-okay. I hope so. I'd really hate for it to not be. Wait, is this even doing its thing? Ha ha ha! Doing technical work. But this will be very engaging. Very, very engaging. So, just need to re-put back in my face. Boop. Boop. Scroll down. Crayon. Okay. Just close that. Alright. Let me just transition on over. Aha, I return. Oh, where's the art program? Ah. Oh, no. It didn't save. Oh, well, at least it's easy to do. Big pain, but we can always just recolor it back in. Ah. Gross. Alright, let's get back on it. Repainting everything. Yeah, still unsure what happened with the whole thing just a moment ago. Just the internet just cut out. And when I go to check it up, Everything was okay. The modem was okay. The router, whatever you want to call it, it's all great. Just my PC just decided to cut everything. And, well, not cut everything. My PC also, I just, yeah. Yeah. Right, so recolor everything again. That's not my brush. That's not my brush. That's my brush. So, back at it again, repainting the base layer of my painting. I'm gonna try and do more lineless art. I know, I just like the look of those art pieces which sort of don't really use an outline for their thing, just sort of painted. Don't know. I kind of like the look of it. Also, because I kind of suck doing like the anime style, but it's what I kind of started off with. Eventually, I will have to, I'll get better. It's an adventure for you and I. Need to turn that off. Right, let's hope that doesn't happen again. The whole shutting down thing, it's a real pain. All right. Shouldn't take too long to get this base layer. I think maybe for the next time I do an art stream, I'll use Procreate. I use that one a lot more than I use Clip Studio. With Clip Studio, it's just a little bit unfamiliar for me, and it doesn't really have a liquify tool. I wish they had a liquify tool. They'll be very. The closest I managed to find is this one here by made by shoot, I forget his name, but it works okay, but it's not quite a liquify tool. It's more of a copy and drag sort of thing. I use this tool to really help me like fix up certain parts. For example, this elbow was sticking out way too much. So I sort of nudged it back in a little bit. But yeah, it'd be really cool if Clip Studios made like a like how they got all these blur things and just made a or even like a filter that messes with maybe the mesh of the painting or something. I don't know how. I'm not very technical when it comes to programming. But if Procreate could do it, or Photoshop can. I don't know what would be stopping Clip Studio. Mean, Clip Studio is pretty popular. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe it's just something that they can't do. Maybe the liquify thing requires some sort of weird prerequisites in the code. Here I am, spouting really stuff I don't really get. So, after I get redo this base layer, Rob's gonna start doing the clothing, just getting all the just the you know the colors, make the get the colors down. Just so I can have an overall look of how Best Girl is gonna look. Was kind of cool today. I watched a little bit of Nyana's and Kiara's collab. I only managed to get like half of it, or even the last third of it. Maybe the last quarter, actually. It wasn't very long. It was kind of cool seeing them both interact. I'm not sure why Kiara was worried. I like about people not liking the collab, maybe gatekeepers or something of that effect. But it's nice. It's good. I'm glad that two content creators from different platforms are able to get together. It's always nice seeing that. Not sure why people would be against the whole thing. It's just a bit sad. But I'm all for it. So, these cat ears. The one... Maybe I'll do the hair. Yeah. Just like that. I do have a dog currently in the room with me right now. At some point I will probably have to put him outside so he can do his little business and have outdoor fun. He's a dog that likes the outdoors and indoors. One of those types of dogs. If you're on my Twitter, I think I posted him a couple of times. Twice, I think. Maybe even I should post him more times, actually, but he doesn't really... He's not a very photogenic dog. All right. So. Yeah. So if I do this and paint it there. Seeing all of the artists on Twitter is just amazing sometimes. It really, really inspires me to draw more often. I see, like, some really, really, really good art, and I'm like, oh, I will reach you eventually. Just give me, like... A few more years, please. I will catch up. I was sifting through my old drawings the other day. Like, the ones I drew from when I was a little slime. And, wow. If you ever have drawings... Well, if you do drawings now, definitely keep them. Don't look at them and cringe and throw them away. Keep them. It's kind of like when a parent takes an embarrassing picture of their child and at their wedding or at their whatever, when they are of age and old, they pull that out and say, "Oh, little Jimmy, this is what you look like doing the dabs. Oh, those were the times." Yeah. I was looking back at my drawings and I'm like, oh, wow. Early 2000s was really edgy. So, if I do this, maybe I should do the lines? Maybe I should... Oh god, I really want to, like, get good at making lines, but I can't. Yet. I will eventually. But... I will. Maybe I should be using my marker. My marker. Where's my marker? I do have this flat marker that you probably see me use a lot. It gives off this like cool thing. It's nice. I kind of like it. It's not ideal sometimes, but sometimes it does give a little, like a, I don't know what, a better appeal to it because of the variations in the way the strokes are made. But maybe I shouldn't be using it for everything. Like the God tool. I guess it's with most things. But yeah. I think I just find myself relying too much on it. This is not how you draw Gura. So, if I have this base down. And with the weird hand there. Okay. I would also like to learn how people do some drawings without using, like, layers or over-reliance on layers. Like, I've seen a couple of people who only have, like, less than 10 layers, and then I see people who use more than, like, 40. 40 or, yeah, like more than 40. And when I see those, I'm like, I would get lost trying to look through all those layers to find out what each layer is. But. Alright, so click that. And now we're gonna do the whatchamacallit, the t-shirt. Maybe we'll do the dress? We'll do the dress. Allow me to quickly grab my reference. My reference. There it is. Okay. So, like, the lower part of the dress is like lighter than the top part. So I'll quickly. I'll grab this color. This color looks. No, yeah, it's all right. Yeah. I want this to be vibrant. My last picture was like a gray blob of mess, no saturation whatsoever. I want this to pop. I want this piece to pop. I'm kind of worried with the jar. If there's one thing I learned, subsurface scattering and see-through things are a pain in the keister. A very big pain in the butt. I wish it didn't exist, but unfortunately, the laws of physics say it has to. So if I quickly do it this way, and the bottom layer, maybe I'll do a separate layer for her bottom dress. Because, like, the bottom dress is, like, ever so lighter. Ever so lighter. So maybe I'll just increase the. Increase that. Lower that. Maybe a little bit more. Just a smidge. Yeah. So that will be the dress. Just slap it on. I'll correct it later. And then with the hair, I think the last time I did her hair, it was like graying. So maybe I'll have a slight tinge of blue in there. That's a very slight tinge of blue. Just ever so slight. So we'll have the white, have a little bit of blue. Just a smidge. That's too much of a smidge. No. Yeah, it's too much. Two blue. There we go. I'll just slather that on. Slather on that blue hair. Just get that going on. Get the cat ears. Yes. And probably I'll use the same for the dress. The top of the dress. Yes, it's all coming together. I hope. So, if I slather it here, and I'll correct it after. Boop, 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 boop. And then the belts, or whatever, the suspenders. On, like, there's one suspender that she has, which is longer than the other. So, it was this one here. So, the suspender is... Maybe for the sake of homogeny, I'll make it the same as the skirt. Just so that we're not playing with too many colors, because too many colors can get a bit... How are you going? At least for the base layer. That I find. Some people like to do it differently. I like to do it this way. So, as I was talking about before... I think, before my stream got cut, and I had to, like, fix everything because my PC decided to kerfuffle. Next time I stream an art stream, I was thinking about doing using Procreate. I'm used to just using Procreate. It's a bit easier for me. Also, because I also use a screen pen. What do you call it? I have a pen for the screen. Well, this one, I like to think I'm okay with the old tablet, but it definitely does help if you're like drawing as if you're drawing on paper, which the iPad sort of does for me. But doing it this way, it's fine too. It just doesn't have the same feel. A couple of friends also have a tablet, and I just keep telling them to use it. You'll get used to it. Eventually, it just becomes second nature. You don't even have to look at the tablet, you just look at the screen. And honestly, you don't need a fancy touch screen or fancy screen thing to do the art. Actually, this one should be a bit gray. This one should be like a gray belt. You don't need like a fancy equipment to draw stuff from what I've done. I mean, I'm not a top artist myself, but with this tablet, I've done, I like to say, decent work. So yeah, it's definitely not a requirement. It's more of a quality of life, quality of life sort of situation. It really makes things, maybe not better, just less, makes it a bit easier, but you definitely don't need it. All right, so, paint that there. Maybe I'll just do the whole, just do it like that, yeah. I don't know if that's gonna get seen. I'll just do it like... Yeah, I'll do it like that, and I'll put the buckle on top. Her dress design is very cute. Kinda reminds me of, a summer dress? Well, I guess it is summer over there for her. Or it gives a very summery feeling. So if I just do that, and then I have to paint the jar on the top part. The jar is going to be a... Maybe I'll just use a multi... I'll just cheat and use a multiply layer. I'll eventually learn how to do subsurface scattering a lot better. I just need to get the ideas and colors down right now. So, if I do this, how about slightly blue tinged? Make a new, new layer, clip it. And then do it like this. If I do it like this, and then apply a certain layered mode to it, will it look somewhat glassy? I would like to hope so. Let's have a look. Hey, that's not... That one's not too bad. Soft light, hard light, vivid light. Oh, I usually use vivid light for some highlight areas, which is nice. Don't know how it works, just looks good. Hard light, exclusive, darken. Lighter, divide. Maybe divide? Maybe I'll just use the soft light for, no, not soft light. I'll use the screen, no, the lighten. Yeah. Screen? Yeah, I'll use lighten for now, but I am definitely going to change it later on. I just need something to see. So I can understand what I'm looking at. I just realized I should have made this base layer a bit more gray. Because the skin's going to be in on top of it. Don't know what I was thinking. So... If I go down to little old edit, tonal correction, hue and luminosity, gray guru. Gray Gura. All right. And now, where on earth? There it is. Ha ha ha. I found you. This needs to be on top, so... I'll lay it there. Yes! So, let me just carefully paint on the wrong layer, and then start painting in the hands. This one actually should be above the jar. The perk of using one layer is you don't have to worry about layers. Unfortunately, I have to use layers. I don't know why Is there a reason why hands are often viewed as being hard to do, to paint? Is it because it's all the intricate parts? Or is it because people don't look at their hands? I don't know. Ooh. So, as one paints the hands, I'm just going to lower down the outline or the sketch again. But, yeah, the music is not that bad. Where I was expecting, like, oops-a-daisy. I was expecting this music not to be very good. Like, YouTube royalty-free sort of things, but this, yeah, it's not too bad. I enjoy it. It's nice and chilled, nice and relaxed. There's a couple of different stations. Boop, 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 boop. I'm just gonna sneak the little bit of arm in here. Yes, excellent. Maybe I'll fuse it a little bit more. Yes, 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 we've got an arm. We have got an arm. Now we'll do the neck. Neck, neck. Yes. So, if... There we go. I'll just... Blah, 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 blah. And I just flop the hair on top. There we go. Ah! Alright. And now the other hand. So, with this one, with this hand, I wanted to kind of be holding the top of the jar. So, maybe I'll have the, maybe the fingers should spread out a little bit more. Yes, I'll do the whole, the, there was a trick that I've seen people do when they're drawing little anime hands. I'm sure a couple of you out there probably seen it as well. Is when, like, when you draw the hands, like, imagine this being the base of a hand, you have your thumb here. And with the index finger, you have it doing its thing. You have the pinky finger doing its thing. But with these two, you sort of track, you sort of keep them as, like, one part. So if you're, like, doing a point, you can, like, point. Oops, let me just erase all this. So, like, when you point, yeah, so that's the pointy finger. You have the three fingers together like this. And, of course, you got your thumbs there. So that's your point. And then you can have, for, like, a little bit of flair, you can have the pinky finger, like, I don't know, doing its own thing. Not the best example. But, yeah, essentially you treat the hand like it has three fingers. And I find it usually helps me sometimes when throwing down art on a paper, just for, like, quick... Wait, what's going on? Ah, I'm using the wrong layer. Using the wrong layer. Yeah, I find it helps me sometimes when I do quick sketches, just to find out how I want things to look. I think the hand might be a bit too big. Please don't crash on me, PC. or program. So, if there are, I think maybe there should be a little bit more. A little bit more raise there. Just raise it up. Just a little bit. Yeah, that looks a little bit more. Yeah. We've got our base layers down. Maybe we should get the face. The face is very important. Face is extremely important. So let's focus on the face for a while, because the face is often the focal point. A bit of a warning, I am not an anime expert. I don't know how to do anime very well. But I will try my best. Let's saturate this. So her eyes. She has very sharp eyes. They're not like Ina's eyes, they don't really slope down. Her eyes are quite sharp. So, just quickly do the whites, the scleras. I want her to be looking like, quizzical. So I need to just make sure I do a couple, shape it correctly. Is she okay that she has cat eyes? I don't think it will be, I don't think they're really cat eyes. Maybe for this one we'll have them like sort of cat-like because she's got cat ears. Yeah. That's not too bad, I think. So, now we do the other eye. Look at that. We have two voids in the faces. Oop, I almost did my wrong thing there. All right. Those are some peepers. Look at those peepers. But if we turn off the guide, where's the guide? Blah. All right. So now that we have the eye shape sort of established, let's draw in those eyelashes after a sip of coffee. Maybe I should have like a little coffee thing here. One sec. I'm gonna go quickly grab a coffee, if I can find myself. I'm gonna memento. I return. Didn't quite find a coffee, but this is pretty close enough. Maybe it's a bit too big. Maybe I'll... Yeah. Okay. Back to drawing. Let's get back to it, gamers. Alright. So... Rotate. Too high. Maybe I'll lower it a little bit. Okay. Bro, Gura, why are your eyes so big? So high. What I also wish is for you to lower the eye a little bit. How does that look? Looking any better? Yeah, I think it's looking alright. Add in those eyelashes, maybe they'll look even better. Alright, so her eyelashes, I think we'll just do with the standard sock. Dark. Darkish. Not pure black. Maybe just a little bit off pure black. Yeah, that looks alright. So when we draw it in, try and pull the viewer's eyes into here. And then while she looks at the shrimp, we'll have the viewers direct their attention to the shrimp. Have the viewer create a story in their head to why Gura has a shrimp in a jar, or what their relationship is between her and the shrimp. That's why I want a quizzical look. Why is she quizzical? Is she laughing at the shrimp? Or is she just fascinated by the shrimp? So, when I rotate, maybe pure black wasn't the way to go. We'll stick at it. We'll keep at it. Doesn't matter if it turns out bad. Art is art, and I enjoy doing it. That's the problem. Hold up. I got a better idea. Just gonna ignore what I said before. These again, I'm just gonna change this. Ignore what I said. Ignore it. Alright. Boop. Do that. Rotate. if I do, like, the more... Yeah, I'm really curious how people do their anime... Anime... The anime look. For the life of me, I cannot recreate it. My eyes are always a bit goofy. I'll have him just be thick. I'll have her, she's wearing mascara now. She's wearing good old mascara. I can always, I'll fix it up later. I'll just have to come back to here. Alright. Let me just rotate 100%. Alright. Yeah, I don't think pure black is the way to go. I think I might just make it a little, like, ever so bluey? Because pure black is a bit harsh, in my opinion. It's a bit harsh. That's too light now. Hey, that's not bad. I don't think that's... Oh, I should probably use my flat brush here. Yeah. I adore those artworks that I see, where you can sort of see the brush strokes in them. The very painterly look, I think it was what people would call it. I enjoy the painterly. Actually, I don't even know. Should I do this more painterly? No, I want to try and branch into some more anime style. I'll keep doing this. Though next time when I get on my on Procreate, definitely gonna do a more painterly style piece. But not sure what I should draw. Maybe I'll ask around and be like, hey, give us ideas. I want to kind of want to draw something. Give us an idea. Alright, stop fiddling with that. Her eyes. Oh, I wonder what color they are. Yep. Give us them blue eyes. Maybe I'll just do it this way so they have a bit more. Maybe that's too big, so maybe we use this as a base. Flat marker. Just carefully erase around. Ever so gently, just ease around and see how that looks. If it looks silly or not. I just want to experiment here. Actually, I'll use my other marker. It's a little bit more rounder. Okay. Should have known something was wrong. Should I just fill it with this? I don't really care too much about the circle anymore. Maybe with the proper circle marker though. Yeah. Kind of want to play Slime Rancher later on tonight. I saw that there was an announcement for Slime Rancher 2, and I got really excited for that. I just adore the art style. Maybe that's what I'll do next time. Maybe I'll do Slime Rancher 2. No, not 2. Slime Rancher art, like art pieces. Because, well, the art style is very vibrant. I love it. Yeah, I think that's what I'll do next time. Let's see how this looks now when I zoom on out. Zoom on out. Squint. Yeah, I think we're getting somewhere. Let me have a quick gander at my reference again. Okay. Huh? Who's this? I don't know who this is. Okay. So, allow me. Please, PC, don't die on me. I beg you. Okay, so if I do this, there it is, it's a shark. Oh, had I not even noticed that thing on her skirt? She has like a stripe down her skirt, and over here too. She also has a handbag, but I'm not really gonna draw it on this in this shot. I'll just leave it out. So she has a dash of red in there. So I'll use this red, this color here. And so I'll use the skirt color for the color on the top of a hair accessory. And then behind it, it's gonna be a reddish. So I'll use this color here. Maybe not pure red. Maybe like a slight pinky. And pl- place it there. And I'll use this red here, or this pinky red, as the accent color. So for like down here, for the skirt part down there, this will be the nice accent color I'll be using. Just the punch through the blue. Alright, now that I have a better view of her clothing. Oh, maybe my eyes are getting worn out. Those are different Hey. Oh no, they are the same color. What am I looking at? Okay, maybe they are the same color. Don't know what, why I thought they were two different colors. Alright, now that we have it like that, Guro is slowly coming together. Let me just save this, save the canvas. Hey, I'm big now. I don't know what happened there. Hold up, maybe I'll just need to quickly lock myself. Save the canvas. Override. How long have I been streaming for? An hour? Alright. Next up. Let me just quickly check something over here. La la la. Okay. Okay. Continue on. Maybe. Oh god. Excuse me as I choke. Maybe I will transition this sort of piece into a more painterly image. I'm just feeling it that way. Don't know about you, but I'm definitely feeling it. Why is this not doing a thing? Excuse me? Is it because... Yeah, okay. Yeah, I think I might, like, transition this somewhat to a more painterly piece. At least we got the base colors down. I'm just not liking... See, when I turn off lines... the edges are very... they're too harsh, they're too solid. So I definitely want to make it a more painterly piece. Let's go back here. We'll just turn on multiply or something. Nope. Multiply. Lower the opacity. Okay, so maybe we'll get started around the face area now. Okay. So So, if I remember correctly, we should drop the color, lower the saturation. I'll try using my flat brush here. Yeah, it's not the right kind of color I wanted. Maybe that's too much. Okay, we'll just do it this way then. Boop. Yeah, that's a bit better. Yeah. Just lock the layer. That's a little bit better. So, it's been a while since I've done, like, an anime face properly. I'm gonna just zoom in a little bit in here. I'm gonna use this marker. Yeah, I think that's looking okay. I think. So the sunlight or the light, I'm gonna have it coming from like up here. Up here? Over here? I'll have it coming, like, over... I'll draw a little light bulb. Just as a visual representation. I'll have the light coming in... from maybe... up here. Coming down at this angle. Like, down... down to, like, here. So that way we have light on the face, and then there's a little bit of shadows. That's my idea, at least. So if the light's coming up here, the nose. Got a little bit of a nose. A little bit of thing there. The mouth. You'll obviously see the mouth. We'll get the corners in. The like the ridge of the nose, there'll be like a shadow there. The eyelids. Just gonna quickly select color again. Just need to fix that up. Eyelids. Let me just redo that. We gotta keep it simple. Anime is the less detail, I think it's better. Or looks better. So we got the little ridge there. We got the shadow from like the face catching on itself. So do that. I'll have to soften these out a little bit. But I just want to get these hard shadows down. And then the hair. And then the shadow from the hair on this side. I said the shadow on this side. And I think there's like a little bit of a shadow down here too. So those are like the hard shadows. Just got a little bit of a nostril situation going on here. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of noses. Noses for me is one of the annoying things to try and paint. I just can't quite get them. Not yet. Maybe I should also do some highlighting as well. Not highlighting, but add more value. See if I do the squint thing. I don't know. All right, so add some nose. the little notes. Add the nostril. Where's my nostrils? Okay, so with the light, we'll just do it this way. So that's his skin. Light. So there'll be light on the... Ooh, that's not light enough. So there would be light on the nose, of course. A little bit of light on the lip. Of course, there'll be light caught on the cheek area, or the cheeks. The forehead area, and the chin. I think the nose needs to be a little bit more. A little bit more like this. Just a smidge. Okay. Let me just zoom out and see how that Play-Doh looks. Yeah, it's some Play-Doh. To be a little bit like that. Sure, we'll do it like that. And there is blood underneath this, so I will have to like add in a little bit of red into this mixture. Like across this part here, I'll probably like go in with a bit of a brush and make a little bit of red. So like, like this. It's too red. Just ever so slightly. Because Gura is a living being. So there would be a little bit of blood underneath her. Gotta get them cheeks. Alright. Maybe I'll just do it now. So I guess go in. Ugh. If I airbrush it in, would it be too... it's not too bad. I'll just do it that way. And then re-go over it. That's not too bad. Then grab my flat marker again. Go over the shadow. Over the shadows. Okay. So. Like that, like this. Grab those highlights. Just a little bit on the cheeks. A little on the nose, or on the cheeks. And then are these too high? Maybe these are too high, so maybe I'll just lower it a little bit. Just a little bit lowering. Flip the canvas. I'll use my marker again. Why is she angry? All right. So, as as we fix up this face a little bit. Probably gonna add in the eyebrow. I forgot to say eyebrows. Alright, so let me just grab in some eyebrows. I think I'll use my flat marker again for this. I love my flat markers. They always make such interesting shapes. We drew the other eyebrow. Flip that. The other eyebrow. Yes. Maybe not like that. Let me fix that up. Yeah. It's looking a bit better. All right. So let's start mixing up the face things now. I'll go grab a brush that I made called, where's brush? Dry brush. There it is. Grab this color and we'll just start working it in a little bit. I want this to be a little bit more softer. Just ever so soft. And over here, because there's like a turn in the form, I'm gonna try and make it not as harsh. Yeah, that's looking like it's turning. Shadow in. Yes, 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 yes. And then with the unsure why this keeps happening. Or maybe it's a reminder for me to save. Saved. Alright, so let me rotate this. Maybe that should be more raised. Where's the eyebrows? I think the eyebrows may be a little bit too high. Lasso this. Put it there. Like this. And then with the other eyebrow, I might move it a little bit downwards. Yes. Okay, one moment. I am just gonna quickly put my dog outside for a moment. It's starting to cause a bit of a ruck. Uno momento. I guess I'll just walk off screen. Okay, I is back. Let's get back to it. Me look at this from a distance again. Maybe there's not enough contrast? Yeah, maybe I'll make it a little bit more darker in the shadow areas. Because I don't feel like there's much depth. I think that's too much more darker. Let me grab my brush. Maybe I'll get back to it later. I'm gonna keep moving on. Keep on keeping on. So, have a little bit of shine in the cheeks. Over at the nose. Yeah, I ain't good with noses. Noses are one of the things I do not enjoy doing. But eventually, hopefully, it'll get better. It's one of those unfortunate things that we all have. Yeah, it's not looking too bad. So Daisy. Boop. Yes. I have harps. Okay, so now with this cheek. So since the light is like directly on this side, I think this side would have to be a little bit more softer. I meant to do that. Whoops, yep, meant to do that too. So, and because of the eye, how this is here, I think it also has its own separate plane. So what if I like grab my marker, just help ease in that plane ever so slightly. Any better? Or does that look stupid? No, yeah, that's not working out. Oh, there's like a little model here I can look at. So, over here, can have like catching light somewhat. And then over here, references really help. References really do help. I'll just do it this way. So, need my brush again. Yeah. How not to draw Gura. 101. What if I just like go full brushy brushy with this? How'd that look? So full brushy brushy, just do it like this, like that. And then with this part here, because she's like raising her eyebrow a little. Where's my. There we go. Nope, that sucks. That's even worse. Brushy, brushy. There we go. That's not really. Great. All right. Like that. Have the kind of look a little old, Gura. I mean, she is 900, 9,000 something, something or other. Of course, she would be old. Needs to be more soft. Maybe if I use air spray. Like, I'm not a big fan of the air spray tool, but sometimes it's just necessary in order to get things done. Now, all right, let's backpedal a little bit. Ha ha ha. In here, I'll just make it darker. Darker. Up here, just make it darker. And then with the airbrush. I think that's looking a bit better. I at least hope so. And then with the hair, we'll grab a flat marker. Maybe we'll work on the hair a little bit too. So that way we have a solid foundation for our shadows. So, if I look at my little reference piece here, so she has like, she's got like that fringe, it's like this. And just do it like this. Boop. And sort of curves outwards. So, boop. Boop. I'll have to cut it up a little bit up there, but for now, just boop. 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 And then hair that comes down just maybe if I secretly do it this way. Bloop, comes down like here. Curves in, so it actually goes like whatever Dickens this is, curves inwards. And then on the other side, we kind of mirror it. The hair does still somewhat like go on her face. Just flip this, this is still balanced. Okay. So, what if I now, where is it? Interesting. All right. Ouch. All right. Maybe I'll have okay, I'm getting pretty hungry, so maybe I'll call this stream it for now. but we'll resume after I had something to eat and had a little break. So for now, I'll have it ended, and we'll continue on soon after.